Good evening. Welcome back to my live music at home concerts. I'm going to start playing tonight with the piano sonata number 347 by Domenico Scarlatti. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. wonderful, kind of little sad, but on the lighter side. The tempo's for Scarlatti. I have a big advantage. This channel is only for me and you. I don't have to please anybody. Sometimes I feel sad that my students who go for competitions have to go through the whole spiel of listening to 10 different piano players and finding out what the current trend in playing a particular piece is. As that goes, I pick music that I like. Not necessarily the music that many people play or listen to. And the tempos are coming from me playing through those pieces and feeling something. And a lot of times my tempos would be slower because not only do I need time to feel things, also the listeners, they need time to be able to feel things as well. So, although quite often our natural tendency is to play something bombastic with a lot of notes and a lot of dynamics and classical piano playing in particular turns into the Olympics. And music is not necessarily a sport. Although hands movement, eye coordination, all of this is as precise as it would be in Olympics. But the point is to make beautiful sounds and to share the feelings those beautiful sounds evoke in me with you. And quite possibly you'd have different feelings, but that's what it's about to me. All right, I'm gonna play a very charismatic piece next. This is Waltz for Debby by Mr. Bill Evans, who was in many ways the brain center of bebop, and particularly complicated chords. And there are still books and books and books about Bill Evans' voicings. Voicings means what notes you play in what hand, that kind of thing. And this is a charismatic piece because it has unusual repeats and the structure elopes you. It's interesting how I used two words in the same episode, evokes and elopes. I wonder how that's related. In this particular piece, the harmony moves around quite freely, as, if I may, it would in Bach's fugue. So it's more difficult to predict and more difficult to remember. Kind of like Coltrane's Giant Steps, also moving around in unusual fashion and very beautiful. I hope you enjoy Waltz for Debby. Thank you. it looks like I'm gonna only get to play one more song. The next one is written by Burke and Lionel Hampton, and you might or might not know. I almost met Lionel Hampton. I won the Lionel Hampton Jazz Festival in Idaho quite a few years ago, and I didn't go to the announcement of the winners because I didn't think I needed to. And one of my friends, Roger Shaw, surprise, called me and said, "Hey, you won." And I was like, "Oh, just shut up and hang up." So if I didn't do that, I probably would have met Lionel Hampton and my life would be just the same, except for the fact that I've met Lionel Hampton. This next tune is called The Midnight Sun.
Thank you.
Like when that happens. Oh my, I'm 5 minutes over. I don't know if you've noticed, but in the first couple of choruses of my solo, what I did is a lot of this kind of voicings, because when you play vibraphone, which Lionel Hampton played that, there's only two mallets in each hand in jazz vibraphone, or even one. But with two mallets in each hand, you can play four note chords, but there is no way you can play five note chord. I hope you enjoyed tonight, and please come back tomorrow night.